Hey, good morning friends. Now we discuss about in this video lesson. On completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know what is greenhouse effect or global warming, sources of greenhouse gases, next causes and effects of greenhouse effect. Okay, what is greenhouse effect or global warming, sources of greenhouse gases, causes and effects of greenhouse effect. And also we discuss about causes and effects of acid rain and depletion of ozone layer. Next, the control methods of air pollution. And also we discuss about causes and effects of acid rain and depletion of ozone layer. Next, the control methods of air pollution. Listen, now we discuss about general effects of air pollution. In that first one, greenhouse effect or global warming. Discuss about greenhouse effect or global warming. This is very, very important topic. The term greenhouse effect was introduced by or coined by J. Fourier. J. Fourier. The term greenhouse effect was introduced or coined by J. Fourier. What is the greenhouse effect or global warming means? The increase in atmospheric temperature due to the increase of some gases is called greenhouse effect or global warming. It means some gases are increased in atmosphere that will be increase the temperature of atmosphere, that is called greenhouse effect or global warming. If some gases are increased in atmosphere, those gases increase the temperature of atmosphere. That increasing of temperature of atmosphere is called greenhouse effect or global warming. So, increase of temperature of atmosphere by increase of some gases in atmosphere is called greenhouse effect or global warming. This effect is also called, because this phenomenon is similar to warming of air inside the greenhouse. The effect is also called, because this phenomenon is similar to warming of air inside the greenhouse. Okay, the gases responsible for greenhouse effect are called greenhouse gases. That means which gases responsible for greenhouse effect are called greenhouse gases. The important greenhouse gases are carbon dioxide, CO2, methane, CH4, ozone, O3, nitric oxide, NO, water vapor, and chlorofluorocarbons. All these gases are greenhouse gases. These gases are responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. Which gases are responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming? Those are carbon dioxide, methane, ozone, nitric oxide, water vapor, chlorofluorocarbons. In these gases, the major greenhouse gas is carbon dioxide. Among these gases, major responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming is CO2. CO2 gas is the major greenhouse gas. Okay. These gases trap more radiation from the sun and increases the temperature of atmosphere. That means these gases like carbon dioxide, methane, ozone, nitric oxide, water vapor, chlorofluorocarbons, these gases present in the atmosphere, those gases absorb more radiation from sun, then temperature of atmosphere will be increased. Okay, these gases are responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. These gases present in the atmosphere, these gases absorb more radiation from sun, then temperature of atmosphere will be increased. That is called greenhouse effect or global warming. In these gases, major responsible for greenhouse effect and global warming is CO2. CO2 is the major greenhouse gas. K, what are the causes of greenhouse effect or global warming? One is the deforestation, next one burning of fossil fuels, excess use of chlorofluorocarbons. Okay, greenhouse effect is caused by deforestation, burning of fossil fuels, excess use of chlorofluorocarbon. Okay, next we discuss about sources of greenhouse gases. Already we know that which gases affect the atmosphere for increasing of temperature. Those gases are called greenhouse gases. In those gases, CO2 is the major responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. So, how the CO2 is introduced into the atmosphere means combustion of fossil fuels, respiration. Okay, CO2 is introduced into the atmosphere by combustion of fossil fuels, respiration. Combustion of fossil fuels produce carbon dioxide, and also respiration also produce carbon dioxide. By this causes, CO2 is introduced into atmosphere. Next one, CH4. How the CH4 is introduced into the atmosphere means decomposition of organic matter from rice fields, coal mines, etc. Okay, from rice fields, coal mines, CH4 is introduced into atmosphere. Mainly, CH4 is introduced by decomposition of organic matter or from rice fields or coal mines, etc. Next one, chlorofluorocarbons. These chlorofluorocarbons are also responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. These chlorofluorocarbons are introduced into atmosphere by refrigerators or ACs. Generally, refrigerators and ACs produce chlorofluorocarbons. Those chlorofluorocarbons are introduced into atmosphere by refrigerators and ACs. Next one, nitric oxide. This is also responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. This is introduced into atmosphere by fertilizers, burning of fossil fuels. Okay. These are the sources of greenhouse gases. CO2 introduced into atmosphere by combustion of fossil fuels, respiration. CH4 is introduced into atmosphere by decomposition of organic matter from rice fields, coal mines, etc. Chlorofluorocarbons are also introduced into atmosphere by refrigerators and ACs. Next, nitric oxide is also introduced by fertilizers, burning of fossil fuels. Okay, listen, this is the greenhouse effect diagram. Greenhouse effect diagram. This is atmosphere. Some greenhouse gases like CO2, CH4, nitric oxide, chlorofluorocarbons present in the atmosphere. So listen, this is atmosphere. Okay, net incoming solar radiation is 240 watts per meter cube. This much of solar radiation is come into the atmosphere. Okay, next, some solar radiation is reflected by the atmosphere and Earth's surface. Outgoing solar radiation is 103 watts per meter cube. Next one, some of the infrared radiation passes through the atmosphere and is lost in space. Net outgoing infrared radiation is 240 watts per meter cube. Listen, next one, solar radiation passes through the clear atmosphere. Incoming solar radiation is 343 per meter square. Next, some of the infrared radiation is absorbed and re-emitted by the greenhouse gas molecules. The direct effect is the warming of the Earth's surface and the troposphere. Next one, surface gains more heat and infrared radiation is emitted again. Next, solar energy is absorbed by the Earth's surface and warms it, 168 watt per meter square, and is converted into heat, causing the emission of long wave radiation back to the atmosphere. This is about the greenhouse effect diagram. Next one, effects of greenhouse effect or global warming. If the global temperature increases by 1 degree centigrade, some effects are predicted. Okay, okay, we discuss about those effects. Okay, listen, melting of ice caps at polar regions, resulting submerging of low-lying areas like Bangladesh, Philippines, Chennai, Goa, etc. మనకు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ టెంపరేచర్ 1 డిగ్రీ సెంటిగ్రేడ్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అయినట్లయితే మనకు పోలార్ రీజియన్స్లో ఉన్నటువంటి ఐస్ క్యాప్స్ అనేటివి మెల్ట్ అవుతాయి. మెల్ట్ కావడం వల్ల వాటర్ అనేటువంటిది మనకు సీ వాటర్ లెవెల్ అనేటువంటిది ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. దానివల్ల లో లయింగ్ ఏరియాస్లో ఉన్నటువంటి బంగ్లాదేశ్, ఫిలిప్పైన్స్, చెన్నై సిటీ, గోవా అంటివన్నీ వాటర్లో మెర్జ్ అయిపోతాయి. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎకోసిస్టమ్. Okay, if 1 degree centigrade increases, affects the ecosystem. That means manaku imbalance avutundi ecosystem lo unnatundi living organisms, non-living organisms madhyala imbalance vachesestundi. Next, decreases surface water and ground water. Manaku surface lo unnatundi water, ground water anetundi manaku decrease avutundi. Endukorakante heat veragadam valla ekkuva ఎవాపరేట్ అయిపోతాయి కాబట్టి సర్ఫేస్ వాటర్, గ్రౌండ్ వాటర్ డిక్రీజ్ అయిపోతుంది. నెక్స్ట్, ఇంక్రీజెస్ ఇన్ఫెక్షియస్ డిసీజెస్ లైక్ డెంగ్యూ, మలేరియా, ఎల్లో ఫీవర్ ఎక్సెట్రా. టెంపరేచర్ ఇంక్రీజ్ కావడం వల్ల మనకు డిసీజెస్ లైక్ డెంగ్యూ, మలేరియా, ఎల్లో ఫీవర్ అనేటువంటివి వస్తాయి. దిస్ ఓకే కెన్ లిజన్ ఇఫ్ 1 degree సెంటిగ్రేడ్ ఇఫ్ ద గ్లోబల్ టెంపరేచర్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ బై 1 degree సెంటిగ్రేడ్ melting of ice caps at polar regions, resulting submerging of low lying areas like Bangladesh, Philippines, Chennai, Goa, etc. Next, affects the ecosystem, decreases surface water and ground water, increases infectious diseases like dengue, malaria, yellow fever, etc. More effects are also predicted. Those are high temperature during winter decreases the yield of cereals and fruits due to reduction in moisture. Next, favors growth of fungus, microorganisms and fish. Next, causes unseasonal rains and cyclones. Okay, some more effects are also predicted. Those are by increasing of 1 degree centigrade of global atmosphere. High temperature during winter decreases the yield of cereals and fruits due to reduction in moisture. Favors growth of fungus, microorganisms and fish. Causes unseasonal rains and cyclones. Okay, listen, this is about the greenhouse effect or global warming. Listen simply. The increase of temperature of atmosphere is called global warming or greenhouse effect. Okay, some gases are responsible for greenhouse effect or global warming. Those gases are carbon dioxide, methane, chlorofluorocarbons, ozone, nitrogen oxides, water vapors. Among these pollutants, CO2 has much effect for the global warming or greenhouse effect. Okay, these gases absorb more light from the sunlight than atmosphere temperature will be increased. Okay, if the global temperature increases by 1 degree centigrade, some effects are predicted. The ice caps of polar regions melt, thereby increase of sea water level. Hence, low lying areas are submerged in the sea water like Bangladesh, Netherlands, Chennai, Goa, etc. Next, the rate of evaporation of water from the hydrosphere increases, which leads to cyclones, unseasonal rains, etc. The agricultural production decreases due to the fast evaporation of surface water. Okay, mainly the global warming can be prevented or reduced by plantation. Okay, global warming or greenhouse effect can be prevented by or reduced by plantation. Okay, this is about the greenhouse effect or global warming. Okay, next we'll discuss about acid rain. Acid rain. What is the acid rain means? The rainwater containing more amount of acids is called acid rain. Okay, acid rain is due to oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. The nitrogen and sulfur oxides dissolve in the rainwater and form nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, sulfurous acid. Okay, listen, the rainwater containing more amount of acids is called acid rain. Acid rain is due to oxides of nitrogen and sulfur. The nitrogen and sulfur oxides dissolve in the rainwater and form nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfurous acid and sulfuric acid. Okay, listen, acidification of water due to pollutants. The pH of acid rain water is less than 5.6. Okay, the acids present in acid rain are H2SO4, H2SO3, HNO2, HNO3, like this. Okay, listen, if industries release nitrogen and sulfur oxides, those oxides dissolve in the water, then that rainwater will become acid rain. That acid rain pH is less than 5.6. Okay, pH value is less than 7, those are acids. pH value is very less than 7, that means 1 to 5, those are more acids. Okay, acidification of water due to pollutant, the pH of acid rainwater is less than 5.6. Okay, industries release nitrogen and sulfur oxides. Those oxides dissolve in water and form sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid, nitrous acid, nitric acid. Then that rainwater will become acid rain. Okay, this is the acid rain. Okay, listen. Okay, definition of acid rain already we have discussed. The rainwater containing more amount of acids is called acid rain. Causes of acid rain already I have explained. Oxides of sulfur and nitrogen released from industries, automobiles and burning of fossil fuels. Listen, oxides and sulfur and nitrogen released from industries, automobiles and burning of fossil fuels. Okay, these are present in the atmosphere. When rain will come, those oxides of sulfur and nitrogen dissolve then and form sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid, nitrous acid, nitric acid. Then rainwater will become acid rain. Okay, next we discuss about effects of acid rain. Effects of building made of marble stones, yellowing of Taj Mahal, stone leprosy. Okay, decreases soil fertility, corrosion to iron structure, increases acidity of drinking water. Okay, effects of acid rain. Okay, Delhi and Agra surroundings low number of industries undadam valla industries nitrogen and sulfur oxides release cheyadam valla akkada rain vachinappudu aa nitrogen and sulfur oxides aa rain lo dissolve avadam valla adi acid rain ga maarutundi. Acid rain manaku padadam valla akkada beautiful ga unnatundi Taj Mahal manaku marble stones tho build up chesindru kabatti dan pain anni scratches anetu yellowish scratches anetuvanti erpatai. దానికి రీజన్ ఏంటంటే యాసిడ్ రెయిన్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ యాసిడ్ రెయిన్ వల్ల సాయిల్ ఫర్టిలిటీ అనేటువంటిది కూడా డిక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. నెక్స్ట్ మనకు ఐరన్ స్ట్రక్చర్స్, ఐరన్ మెటీరియల్తో తయారు చేసినటువంటి స్ట్రక్చర్స్, మిషనరీ పార్ట్స్ ఈజీగా కరోజన్ అవుతాయి. నెక్స్ట్ డ్రింకింగ్ వాటర్లో కూడా యాసిడ్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అవ్వడం వల్ల మనకు హెల్త్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కూడా అవుతాయి. ఓకే, లిజన్, ద ఎఫెక్ట్స్ are absorbed due to acid rain. There, the life of building and other constructions will be reduced. The glossy nature of Taj Mahal is reducing due to acid rains. The life of aquatic animals is affected. Next, the fertility of the soil decreases, which results in low agricultural production. The acidity of drinking water increases, which causes acidity in human beings. Okay, listen, these are the effects of acid rain. Okay, listen, let's just I explained. Nitrogen and sulfur oxides present in water, nitrogen and sulfur oxides are released from industries. Those are present in the atmosphere. When rain will come, those oxides dissolve and form nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid. Reactions are like this. N2. Plus H2O. Gives HNO, nitrous acid HNO2. Next, nitrogen pentoxide. Nitrogen pentoxide react with water and gives nitric acid. It is 2HNO3. Nitric acid, similarly, sulfur dioxide SO2 react with water and form sulfuric acid 2HSO3. Next, sulfur trioxide also dissolve in water gives 2HSO4. Sulfuric acid okay, listen. Industries release nitrogen oxides and sulfur oxides. These are present in the atmosphere. When rain will come, these oxides dissolve in water and form nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid. Then rainwater will become acid rain. This is about the acid rain. This is the effects water plants and aquatic animals by acid rains, like this one. Okay, next we discuss about another one, that is ozone layer depletion. Ozone layer depletion. First we discuss about ozone. Ozone layer present in the stratosphere. This ozone layer acts like a protection layer for UV light. This ozone layer prevents entering of UV light into troposphere. Okay, listen, ozone layer manaku stratosphere lo untundi. Idi atmosphere lo 4 parts untunnayi manaku, troposphere, stratosphere, next ionosphere, thermosphere. Okay, ikkada stratosphere lopala manaku ozone layer untundi. అది యూ సన్ నుంచి వచ్చే యూ రేస్ ను ఎంటర్ కాకుండా ప్రొటెక్ట్ చేస్తుంది. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ ద డిప్లిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఓజోన్ లేయర్ ఈజ్ డ్యూ టు క్లోరోఫ్లోరోకార్బన్స్, నైట్రిక్ ఆక్సైడ్ అండ్ క్లోరిన్. డిప్లిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఓజోన్ లేయర్ ఈజ్ డ్యూ టు క్లోరోఫ్లోరోకార్బన్స్, నైట్రిక్ ఆక్సైడ్ అండ్ క్లోరిన్. ఓకే, అట్మాస్ఫియర్ లోపలికి క్లోరోఫ్లోరోకార్బన్స్ నైట్రిక్ ఆక్సైడ్ క్లోరిన్ రిలీజ్ కావడం వల్ల ఓజోన్ లేయర్ లోపల మనకు డిప్లెషన్ ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. సో ఓజోన్ లేయర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ స్ట్రాటోస్ఫియర్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ ఎర్త్ ఫ్రమ్ హార్మ్ఫుల్ యూవీ రేడియేషన్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ causes of ozone layer depletion. Collision. Chlorofluorocarbons are released or liberated from air conditioners and industries. Nitric oxide released from supersonic jet planes and chlorine released from industries or eruption of lava. They are stable in troposphere but more reactive in stratosphere due to high temperature. They react with ozone and causes holes in the ozone layer. As a result, more energetic UV lights enter into the troposphere. Okay, listen. Chlorofluorocarbons, these are called prions also. These chlorofluorocarbons are prions released from cooling systems and refrigerators. Nitric oxide released from supersonic jet planes. Chlorine released from industries and ఎరప్షన్ ఆఫ్ లావా. ఇవి మనకు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ లోపలికి రిలీజ్ అయినప్పుడు ట్రోపోస్ఫియర్లో ఇవి స్టేబుల్గా ఉంటాయి. దానికంటే పైన ఉన్నట్టు స్ట్రాటోస్ఫియర్లోకి వెళ్ళినప్పుడు అక్కడ టెంపరేచర్ ఇంక్రీజ్ అవుతుంది. ఆ హై టెంపరేచర్లో ఇవి ఓజోన్ లేయర్తో రియాక్ట్ కావడం వల్ల ఓజోన్ లేయర్ లోపల మనకు డిఫ్లేషన్ అనేటువంటిది ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. ఈ డిఫ్లేషన్ ఫామ్ అవడం వల్ల కొన్ని ఎఫెక్ట్స్ మనకు కనిపిస్తాయి. నెక్స్ట్ వి డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఓజోన్ లేయర్ ఎఫెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ నెక్స్ట్ వి డిస్కస్ effects. Okay, next, formation of ozone hole. Okay, there is release of chlorofluorocarbons causing ozone holes. That means release of chlorofluorocarbons, nitric oxide and chlorine causing ozone holes. Ozone hole is identified in Antarctica region. Ozone hole is identified in Antarctica region. Ozone layer looks like a umbrella. If some holes present in umbrella, that is looks like a depletion of ozone layer. Okay, next we discuss about effects of ozone layer depletion. Okay, when holes occur in ozone layer, some effects are observed. Those are causes skin cancer, causes cataract problem, damages plants and wildlife, decreases in photosynthetic rate, increases in atmospheric temperature. Okay, manaku ozone layer lo deflection vachinappudu UV rays direct ga manaku troposphere lo enter kavadam valla avi human beings paina effect chustayi. Ee oka UV rays enter ayinatlayite skin cancer anetundi vastundi. Next, disease like cataract formation, the kante diseases, eye diseases vachestayi. Okay, next, increasing of atmospheric temperature, so adi kuda global warming reason avutundi. Life of aquatic animals is also affected. Next, decreases the photosynthesis in the plants. All those effects of ozone depletion. Okay, causes skin cancer, causes cataract, damages plants and wildlife, decreases in photosynthetic rate, increases in atmospheric temperature. Okay, listen. It is known that air pollution due to industries, automobiles like vehicles. Next, how the pollution is controlled? Suggest a method to purify the air. Okay, next we discuss the methods of control of air pollution. Methods of control of air pollution. Okay, listen. Okay, some methods are used to control the air pollution. Air pollution is a major problem and the consequences are posing a challenge for the environmentalists. It's not possible to prevent the air pollution, but it can be minimized or controlled. The following methods are used. Some methods are used to control or reduce the air pollution. Okay, those are reduction of contaminants in the source, reduction of contaminants to modifying raw materials. Next, dilution of source discharge, use of alternative fuels, afforestation, Next, joining of industries. Okay, these methods are used to control the air pollution. One is reduction of contaminants in the source. Next, reduction of contaminants to modifying raw materials. Next, dilution of source discharge, use of alternative fuels, afforestation, and joining of industries. Okay, listen. Pollution. Okay, next, we discuss about reduction of contaminants from source. Pollutant concentration is reduced by these following methods. Smoke can be reduced from fuels by correct method of firing, admitting correct quantities of air, next, maintaining high temperature, feeding the fuel continuously. Listen, reduction of contaminants from source. Pollutant concentration is reduced by these methods. Smoke can be reduced from fuels by correct method of firing, admitting correct quantities of air, maintaining high temperature, next, feeding the fuel continuously. Okay, listen. Pollutant concentration is reduced by following method: by using catalytic converters, by using chemical scrubbers, acids and fumes are removed by passing through coke. Okay, listen. Pollutant concentration is reduced by these methods: by using catalytic converters, next, by using chemical scrubbers, acids and fumes are removed by passing through coke. Okay, listen. Okay, listen. Reduction of contaminants by modifying raw materials, modification of internal combustion engine, use of substitute fuels like ethyl alcohol, LPG, etc. in place of petrol. Listen, reduction of contaminants by modifying raw material, modification of internal combustion engine, use of substitute fuels like ethyl alcohol, LPG, etc. in place of petrol. Okay, listen. Okay, next, listen. Dilution of source discharge by using catrel electrostatic precipitator, by using large chimneys, by using gravity settling chambers, cyclone collectors, wet scrubbers, etc. Okay, control of pollution by dilution. By using tall stacks or chimneys, the concentration of air pollutants is reduced at the ground level. The gases liberated through the stalks get diluted and are dispersed into the atmosphere. This is the electrostatic precipitator. Listen. Next, listen. Use of alternate fuels. Pollution level is reduced by using non-conventional energy sources. That means already you know that non-conventional energy sources means elant pollutant U120. Energy sources. Important non-conventional energy sources are hydroelectricity, solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, tidal energy, etc. Now, hydral energy ni use chesinatlayite reservoirs lo nunchi manaku hydral energy generate avutundi, elanti pollutants nu release cheyadu. Next, solar energy ni use chesukoni photovoltaic plates dwara electricity ni produce chesina elanti pollutants nu release cheyadu. నెక్స్ట్ విండ్ ఎనర్జీ జియోథర్మల్ టైడల్ ఎనర్జీస్ కూడా మనకి ఎలాంటి పొల్యూటెంట్స్ రిలీజ్ చేయవు అదే మనకు కోల్ యూజ్ చేసి ఎలక్ట్రిసిటీ ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేసినట్లయితే పొల్యూటెంట్స్ రిలీజ్ చేస్తాయి కాబట్టి ఆ కోల్ బదులు ఈ యొక్క ఆల్టర్నేట్ ఫ్యూయల్స్ నుంచి ఎలక్ట్రికల్ ఎనర్జీని ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేస్తే మనకు ఎయిర్ అనేటువంటిది పొల్యూట్ కాకుండా ఉంటుంది నెక్స్ట్ అఫారెస్టేషన్ ఆర్ డిఫారెస్టేషన్ సో గ్రోయింగ్ ఆఫ్ మోర్ ట్రీస్ సోషల్ ఫారెస్ట్రీ మనము ఎక్కువ ట్రీస్ ని ప్లాంటేషన్ చేసినట్లయితే మనకు అది ఎయిర్ ను పొల్యూట్ కాకుండా చేస్తుంది నెక్స్ట్ ట్రీస్ ను కూడా మనము కట్ చేయకుండా ఉండాలి దీస్ ఆర్ ద కంట్రోలింగ్ మెథడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎయిర్ పొల్యూషన్ లిజన్ పొల్యూషన్ కంట్రోల్ ఎట్ ద సోర్స్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్ సమ్ మెథడ్స్ మే బి ఎంప్లాయ్డ్ టు కంట్రోల్ ఎయిర్ పొల్యూషన్ ఎట్ ద సోర్స్ దోస్ ఆర్ చేంజ్ ఆఫ్ రా మెటీరియల్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ డీసల్ఫరైజ్డ్ కోల్ ఈస్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ కంబషన్ చేంజ్ ఆఫ్ రా మెటీరియల్ For example, desulfurized coal is used for combustion. modification of the process so as to eliminate the pollutant. Next, developing of new equipment, for example, two-stroke engines are replaced by four-stroke engines. Emission of carbon monoxide from vehicles is reduced by using catalytic converters. Next, using chemical scrubbers, a suitable chemical reagent is used to absorb the pollutant. SO2 is removed by using lime water. Next, control air pollution by reduction of smoke from vehicles. Smoke can be reduced or eliminated from the vehicles by some steps. One is correct method of firing, admitting required amount of air, maintaining a high temperature, feeding the fuel continuously, using modern fuels. Next one, control of pollution by dilution. By using tall stacks or chimneys, the concentration of air pollutants is reduced at the ground level. The gases liberated through the stacks get diluted and are dispersed into the atmosphere. Next one, control of pollution by plantation. Plants are very effective in controlling of air pollution. Plants use CO2 in the photosynthesis and release O2, so they help to reduce CO2 in the atmosphere. They act as receptor for many air pollutants. Next, listen. Next lesson, joining of industries. Air pollution is also controlled by joining of industries. What is the joining of industries? Listen, it is one of the important steps to control the air pollution. In the planning of a city or town, the area is divided into different zones like residential zones and industrial zones. The industrial zones and residential zones are separated by buffer zones, that is plantation. Because of this joining system, air pollutants are diluted by the time they reach to residential zone. The process is joining of industries. Then, next, air pollution is also controlled by application of biocides properly, control over use of radioactive substances, mass awareness. Listen, the use of control of pollution by using modern fuels. The use of conventional fuels like wood, coal and petroleum products should be reduced or minimized. The modern and non-conventional fuels like wind energy, solar energy, hydro energy, nuclear power, geothermal energy, etc. should be used to control the air pollution. These are the controlling methods of air pollution. Next, what we have discussed in this video lesson. Okay, one is greenhouse effect. Next, causes of greenhouse effect. Next, effects of greenhouse effect. We have also discussed acid rain, causes and effects of acid rain. Next, depletion of ozone layer. Next, causes and effects of ozone layer depletion. We have also discussed air pollution is controlled by reduction of contaminants from source, dilution of source discharge, afforestation, joining of industries, mass awareness. Next, we also discuss some multiple choice questions. Which of the following is a greenhouse gas? CO2, NO2, SO2, Cl2. Okay, in this, major greenhouse gas is CO2. So our answer is A. A is the correct answer. So many greenhouse gases are there: carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxides, methane, okay, chlorofluorocarbons. In among these greenhouse gases, CO2 is the major responsible for global warming or greenhouse effect. Next, we discuss another question. Which of the following is not a greenhouse gas? CH4, N2O, O3, O2. Which of the following is not a greenhouse gas? That is, CH4 is a greenhouse gas, ozone is a greenhouse gas, N2O is also greenhouse gas, O2 is not a greenhouse gas. So our answer is D. D is the correct answer. D is the correct answer. Okay, next we discuss another question. That is, the increase in temperature is due to A, greenhouse effect, B, acid rain, C, afforestation, D, lead. So A is the correct answer. Okay, increasing of temperature of atmosphere is called greenhouse effect or global warming. already we have discussed tailed gun. Next, which of the following oxides causes acid rains? CO, nitrogen oxide, magnesium oxide, Na2O. A, CO, B, NO2, C, MgO, D, Na2O. B is the correct answer. Nitrogen oxide is the correct answer. Actually, industries release nitrogen and sulfur oxides. Those oxides are nitrogen. Those oxides like NO2 and nitrogen oxide, sulfur oxides present in the atmosphere. When rain will come, those nitrogen and sulfur oxides dissolve and form nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfurous acid and sulfuric acid. So B is the correct answer. Next one, Taj Mahal is affected by greenhouse effect, acid rain, ozone depletion, all the above. Mainly Taj Mahal is affected by acid rain. Okay. Atmosphere lo industries nunchi release ayya nitrogen sulfur oxides undadam valla rain vachinappudu aa rain lo nitrogen sulfur oxides dissolve avadam valla nitrous acid, nitric acid, sulfurous acid, sulfuric acid ostayi. Appudu rain acid rain ga maarutundi. Acid rain Taj Mahal pai padapudu dan pane yellow scratches vachesnay. So B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. And next one, ozone layer is present in ionosphere, mesosphere, stratosphere, troposphere. Actually, atmosphere is divided into four types. One is troposphere. First layer is the troposphere, second stratosphere, third mesosphere, fourth ionosphere. Actually, ozone layer present in the second one, that is stratosphere. So our answer is C. C is the correct answer. Ozone layer is present in stratosphere. Next, depletion of ozone layer causes skin diseases, lung diseases, heart diseases, all the above. Okay, depletion of ozone layer causes skin diseases, lung diseases, heart diseases, all the above. So all are correct. Mainly skin diseases. So A is the correct answer. Depletion of ozone layer causes skin diseases. Why? Because ozone layer lo holes form ainatlayite, holes nunchi UV rays direct ga earth pai kochinappudu human being యొక్క skin పై వస్తే skin diseases అనేవి వచ్చేస్తాయి. So next, the carbon particles from smoke can be completely removed by cyclone collector, catrel electrostatic precipitator, chimney, catalytic converter. Catrel electrostatic precipitator. B is the correct answer. So the carbon particles from smoke can be completely removed by using catrel electrostatic precipitator. B is the correct answer. Next, which of the following energy source causes pollution? Which of the following energy source causes pollution? Hydroelectricity, thermal electricity, geothermal energy, solar energy. So this is thermal electricity sources cause of pollution. So B is the correct answer. B is the next. Afforestation increase pollution, increases CO2, decreases pollution, no effect on pollution. Okay, decreases pollution, decreases pollution. So C is the correct answer. Okay, next, okay, listen, next, what we have discussed in the video lessons, some questions are frequently asked in the examination. What those are? One is, what is greenhouse effect? Second, write a notes on global warming. What is acid rain? What are the effects of it? Write a note on ozone layer depletion. Explain different control methods of air pollution. Next question, write short notes on electrostatic precipitator joining of industries. Okay, listen, these questions are frequently asked in the examination. What is greenhouse effect? Write a note on global warming. Next question, what is acid rain? What are the effects of it? Write a note on ozone layer depletion. Explain different control methods of air pollution. Next, write short notes on A, electrostatic precipitator. Next, joining of industries. Listen. Thank you for the listening of this video lesson. Okay, what we have discussed in the video lesson in global warming or greenhouse effect. Next one, ozone layer deflation. Next, acid rains. Next, we also discuss controlling methods of air pollution. Okay.